Hey guys, welcome back to another ChemSketch tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at setting up reactions and a few of the other features that you can do when you're drawing structures with ChemSketch. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay guys, this is kind of where we left off last time, so we'll just pick up here. As you can see, we've got the structures that we drew last time. I want to put all this in the same file. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a page. If you look down here at the bottom, you can notice that it says page 1 of 1. And there are some buttons here that you can move back and forth between pages, except there's really only one page now. So we can go to the top and we can hit pages, new, and it'll put a second page on there. So now we can move between the pages we have. If you want to delete a page, you can just go back to the top and hit pages, and then click on delete. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and get started with drawing some reactions, and we're gonna start with a basic decomposition. So I'm gonna start with calcium carbonate, and if you remember, when I put my calcium down, it's gonna show up as an ion because it's a metal. And then carbonate, if you guys remember from chemistry, is a polyatomic ion, and it's gonna have a carbon and 3 oxygen. Need a double bond there. Okay, so of course, because these are nonmetals, it automatically puts the hydrogen on there. And since this is a polyatomic ion, we want to get those off of there. So there's a little feature that you can do down here. So if you look at the bottom, you see the little plus sign, and then there's a little arrow. You click on this arrow, and we can do plus or minus. I wouldn't mess with these other ones here right now, but we're going to do minus because we want to decrease the charge. So when I click on this, it will remove the hydrogen and give a negative charge to the oxygen, and that's going to give my structure an overall -2 charge, which is what carbonate has. So I can take this if I want, and I can go ahead and clean it up. Now, if I want this -2 charge to be more over here pointed towards my calcium, it doesn't really have to be, but if I wanted to show it that way, I can actually do something a little different with select than what I showed you the last time. If you go up here and hit select, rotate, resize, it changes the way the select works. So now if I move my cursor, you can see if I move it to the right spot, you'll see a little rotation arrow come up, and I can just turn this to whatever angle I want it to, and I can just spin it around there. Now you can do this with any of your structures if you want to twist them or move them different than what they already show up. Okay, so now I've got my calcium and my carbonate, and we know when that decomposes, it's going to make calcium oxide. So I can just put me another calcium, and I go to put my oxide, but of course, like it did last time, it puts my hydrogens on there. So I can go back down here. Now my minus is already kind of put as default, and I can change this to its -2 ion, so I can show that as a cation and an anion. We also know that this is going to make CO2 gas. So I can put my carbon and go ahead and build my CO2. You know, I don't really see the carbon here on my carbonate, and since it's such a small molecule, a lot of times you may want to show that. So I'm going to introduce you to something we haven't really talked about yet, and that is styles. So if I highlight this structure and I right click on it, I can go to Object Properties. Now another way to get to this is you can go up to Tools, Structure Properties, so you can see it there as well. So once you have your Object Properties, you can see there's lots of things you can do here with the atom and the bond and the coloration, but we're just going to do a couple of simple things here. First thing is show carbons. Right now it's clicked off, and I want to show all my carbons. And when I hit apply, you can see it'll only apply it to the structure that I have selected, and it's going to show the carbon on this, and so I can see it just like I was wanting to do. Now there's lots of other things you can do with styles. So for example, if I want to maybe change the size of my atoms or make them bold or make the bonds larger, I can do that. So let's take this auto, basically means that as you change the atom size, the bond size is going to change with it, kind of to match. If you unclick this, you can change your atom size and your bond length independently of each other. So now I'm going to hit apply, and you can see that it's made this whole thing larger. Now, if you want, you can set all this up and you can set your style as a default, and I'm not going to do that right now. But something else you can do, if I take another structure, let's say you do this, you save it, and you come back later and you think, oh, well, these are not styled the same way that this one is. So you can select another structure. You can hit Object Properties, and you can see that it's not going to be the same style as the other one. So what you can do is you can hit Update From. I can go over here and click this structure, and it's going to pull in the same style as this structure, so I can apply it to my other structures. Now I can just start selecting my other structures and applying that style to all my other structures so they match up. So that's handy if you have structures that you wound up getting slightly different in their style and you want to get them to match up. Okay, so you can X that out when you're done with it, or you can just leave it up. It doesn't really matter. So now that I'm done with this, I need to put in, I've got all my reactants and my products, but I need to put the rest of the reaction in. So up here, we can get us a reaction arrow. So I can do a couple different ways. I can just click and it's going to put a short arrow there. If I want a longer arrow, I can just physically draw a longer arrow. And then of course I can take that arrow and I can put it wherever I want it. So let's delete this one, get rid of it. Here's a plus that I can use. And also we can label our arrows. So let's say that in this particular case, we know that a decomposition reaction needs heat. So if I go here to my reaction arrow labeling and I click, it'll give me the option to label this arrow either above it or below it. I want to label it above it. I can type in anything I want here, but delta means heat and it's already there for me. So I'm just going to do that. And you can see it puts it right above the arrow. So it's there and ready to go. So now that I've got this done, I'm going to move for the first time into drawing mode. So in drawing mode, I can do a few more things. First of all, I'm going to select everything. And you'll notice up here, I have the ability to flip things around. I can flip them left and right, top to bottom. I can rotate them 90 degrees. I can align them to the left. But I want to align these guys to the center because I want them all to match up so we just kind of come straight across in a line. So once I've done that, now if I pick my structures, another good thing that you can do is I can take these two since they kind of belong together in the same compound and I can group them. So if I hit the group, now they'll behave as a group. So they won't, I won't accidentally move one instead of the, and not get the other with it. Also with this, I don't think I ever actually cleaned, I'm gonna go back to structure mode. I don't think I ever actually cleaned this one up. All right. I'm gonna move this one over as well. And I'm gonna line these up before I group them. And then I've been shifting stuff around. Oops, something I noticed that I did was I moved when I lined everything up. Now that I have everything like I want it, I'm going to select everything and I'm going to center it up or line everything up on their centers. However, I really don't want to do that with my delta sign here. So I'm going to hit shift and I'm going to unselect that little delta sign and then I'm going to line everything else up with my center vertically. Okay, everything looks good now. Everything's centered up. All right, now that I've got this done, there's some other things we can do. There's some other things that we can do. I'm going to move this over just a little bit with my arrow keys. There's several things we can do here. We can put labels. Of course, we can put labels in structure mode as well. I can put, you know, I can draw shapes. I can draw lines. I can draw different arrows. There's lots of things you can do in this raw mode that you can't necessarily do as easily in the structure mode. So it helps you just kind of put some polish on your reactions or whatever it is you're doing. So this is a basic overview of how to set up a reaction. One more thing that I think is important to mention since we're talking about charges. So if we go back to structure mode here, and if we want to look at something, you know, a lot of times our metals like calcium and potassium, they have pretty much one charge based on their position in the periodic table. However, transition metals have more than one oxidation state. So if we pick something like iron, it's just going to pick like a Fe2+ oxidation state of 2. And if we need to change that, we can also use this negative button down here to switch between, doesn't matter which one you use. When you click this, it'll start switching between the typical oxidation states. And it'll actually skip over the ones that you don't see. Like you don't see Fe+, so it just jumps automatically to Fe2+, 3, 4, 6, then it goes back. Now if I wanted to look at something different, let's pick a different element that's not up here. So when we pull up this periodic table, we can look at several of our elements here, chromium, for example, and it'll tell you it has oxidation states of 2, 3, and 6. Manganese has 2, 3, 4, 6, and 7. So if I want to draw a manganese, and then I want to switch between the oxidation states, you'll see it'll actually go between all the possible oxidation states, and then it'll kind of rotate back around. So it'll typically just kind of rotate between the available oxidation states. So this can be handy if you want to do a structure that has a metal in it and it doesn't come up in the right oxidation state. You can just switch the oxidation states, and it actually doesn't matter if you use the minus or the plus. The plus just steps it up and the minus just steps it down, but you can use either one. All right. So that's going to probably do it for today. Guys, I appreciate it. I thank you for listening, and hope to see you back soon. Okay, that'll finish us up for today. If you found this video useful, don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. And join us next time. We'll be talking about how to draw lab setups in ChemSketch. See you then.